to WHS News. I'm your host, Wendy Vu.
And I'm Kevin Nguyen.
Do you have a special person in mind this holiday? The Vietnamese American Culture Club will be selling Christmas grams within the next 2 weeks, so be sure to stop by Abbey Square during lunch to purchase a gram for $3. This includes a special song dedicated to your special person along with a holiday hat.
In order to purchase a gram for that special somebody, a third or fourth period is necessary. Don't miss out on a chance to let someone know you care.
Hi, I'm Brian Chin, and guess what? It's Tuesday. Are you feeling hungry? Come to WHS Food Trucks today from 4:30 to 8:30 p.m. Come dine on delicious food like Longboard's ice cream and Dogzilla while supporting your school. So come out every Tuesday and enjoy the great food.
On December 6th, we will be having a special event. The Medical Healthcare Unit will be coming and providing free medical services, which includes the flu, Tdap shots, vision hearing, and dental checks, etc. We will also be collecting toys for Toys for Tots. Bring in a new or unwrapped toy for these kids for the holiday season.
And here's Jeffrey with a commentary on internet censorship.
The 1960s introduced a new technological advancement that changed the world forever, the internet. Since its creation, the internet has brought about many positive upbringings. It offers convenience and has greatly impacted human communication, for it is a gateway to self-expression and creativity. However, the U.S. Congress is currently debating a law that would give them the power to censor the world's internet and shut down websites that contain copyright infringement material. These include websites we use every day, such as YouTube, Google, Facebook, Twitter, and many more. The internet censorship bill could pass at any time, and if it does, the internet and our freedom of speech will never be the same. But we can help stop this. Sign up now at americancensorship.org and spread the word as widely as possible. Together we can stop the Congress from passing this bill. The internet is a crucial tool for people around the world to exchange ideas and work collectively to build the world we all want. We urge everyone to show true global leadership and protect our rights.
Now here is Manuel with a report on the attack of the Iranians on our drones.
I'm Manny Lino, and just last week in western Afghanistan, a secret U.S. surveillance drone appeared to have crashed in Iran in what may be the first case of such an aircraft ending up in the hands of an adversary. Iran says the drone they shot down is an RQ-170 and unnamed. Unarmed aircraft used to gather intelligence and targeting information as it flew over Iranian airspace. The United States say that their drones don't fly over the Iranian airspace. Now, if Iran should keep their possession of the aircraft, then it should mark a significant setback for the U.S. military. The United States has lost many less sophisticated unnamed aircrafts in recent years over Iran, but a nearly intact RQ-170 could offer a potential windfall of useful intelligence for the Iranians and their allies.
Now here's Christina with a report on stranger danger.
Just the other week, a female from Westminster High School was offered a ride from a middle-aged man in a white four-door van. Luckily, our student remained unharmed, but the outcome could have been completely different had she not taken the proper precautions. Here are some helpful hints for you to take if you are ever put in her situation. Walking to and from school, try to take a path on big crowded streets where you will be viewed of many people. Always try to walk with a friend, and if this is not possible, make sure your cell phone is with you at all times. Stay safe, Lions.
Now here's Jenny Dang and Lorianne Tran with College Knowledge.
Hey Lions, welcome to another segment of College Knowledge. Today's college is Virginia Polytechnic Institute and State University, also known as Virginia Tech. It is a public university located in Blacksburg, Virginia. Founded in 1872 as an agricultural and mechanical land grant college, Virginia Tech is the largest full-time student population in Virginia and one of the few public universities in the United States that maintains a corps of cadets. This 2,600-acre campus offers about 65 bachelor's degree programs through its 7 undergraduate academic colleges. Business management is one of the most popular majors, along with engineering, biology, psychology, and computer science.
The A typical student who was offered admission had a high school grade point average of a 4.0, an average SAT score of 1250, and an average ACT score of 25. Until 1932, every able-bodied male was required to participate for 4 years in the Virginia Tech Corps of Cadets. The requirement was changed to 2 years until 1964, when participation became voluntary. Virginia Tech remains one of the three public universities in the country with both an active corps of cadets and civilian lifestyle on its campus. On April 16, 2007, unfortunately, Virginia Tech suffered one of the worst acts of violence against students in 2007. The senseless act has been overcome by new policies and a top-ranked athletic program. That's all for now. Tune in next time for another segment of College Knowledge, where we bring information about universities and colleges to you.
That's all for now, Lions. Stay tuned for next week's of WHS News. I'm Kevin Nguyen.
And I'm Wendy Vu.
Bye!